what is the true gospel? You see, as someone that's told me that if you have problems with counterfeit bills, and that this is when they talk about the bank, what you need to know is what the original bill looks like. If you understand what God looks like, then you can spot a counterfeit. So, I like how Pastor
is that your therapy girl?
The sermon. So I'm going to ask you this question. When I say the word gospel, what comes to mind? When I say the word gospel, what comes to mind? You can talk. Good news, right? Dying man, good news. What else? Great grace. Can I hear somebody back there? Good. Free gift. Wonderful. And a free gift that doesn't cost anything. I might say the word Jesus somewhere. Right? I mean, there's certain things you just assume. What else? Come on. Could you define the gospel? If you're Kurt sitting with that man from Pakistan and you wanted to share what the gospel means, now you might not be what you call an evangelist, but you should be able to share what the gospel is. What's the gospel? It's interesting, as I think about that, I go to Paul. He says there's a different gospel, which is really no gospel. Well, what's the true gospel then, Paul? And Paul says, you know, I taught it to you. I want you to know, brothers and sisters, verse 11 of that first chapter of Galatians. I want you to know that the gospel I preached is not of human origin. I received it from God. It's a revelation from Jesus Christ. You know, here's the gospel. And I want to go back to Acts chapter 13. This is where he preached. He's referring back to when he was in Galatia, and he says, this is what I preach. I tell you good news of the gospel, right, Donnie? Good news. That's the word. It's actually, just if you like to be impressed with Greek, euangelion, that's the gospel. And euangelion is angel. It's a message. And EU at the front in Greek means good. It's a good message. What God promised our ancestors, he's fulfilled for us by raising up Jesus from the dead. The gospel is about Jesus.